spiritual powers over our lives, and he shamed them publicly, and it's by his victory that he claimed on the cross for us that we can stand this morning. We can come and worship him. Do you believe that this morning? So come on, let's lift our voices. Let's sing this out.
I hear the Savior say, thy strength indeed is small. Child of weakness, watch and pray. Find in me thy all in all.
Sing it out.
Jesus paid it all to him I owe.
everyone. So good to see all of you here today. My name is Alan, and I'm so thankful that we get to be celebrating and leaning into and worshiping God because of His grace that is for us. And just a quick glimpse into my story, I can remember the very first time I ever experienced just the overwhelming grace of God. I was 17 years old. And I had just gotten off of work. I worked at P.F. Chang's because as a teenager, I had an infatuation with money and Mongolian beef. And that was where I was at 17. And I remember getting off of work, and God had been doing some things in my life. And I kind of wandered into this service, a church service, and talked with some people, and they prayed for me. And there was just this incredible chain of events that took place. And I remember experiencing the grace of God, and there was this crazy tug of war that was going on. And I remember one of the very first thoughts that I had in receiving God's grace was just, and this is what I've been looking for all along. Like, this is what I've always wanted but never knew it was available. It was almost this, like, why didn't anybody tell me about this? Like, where was the invite or the message? Or it was just this confusing thought of just, I thought the things that I was going after, the things that I thought I wanted so deeply, I thought that was what life was all about, but I'm realizing that this is what I've wanted all along. And I don't know if you've ever felt that. Maybe that's today what you may experience, just this moment of God's overwhelming grace, meeting you in a place where you can almost run a list of, well, I've tried that, or I've gone there, or I've been in this place, or I've attempted this, and just nothing satisfies. And what I know God wants me to communicate today is that every one of us have this void in our heart that is unavoidable. There's a void that's in us that can only be filled by the grace of God. And if you have been trying or looking for or attempting to be satisfied by things in this world, and those things have left you worse off than they found you, then today I want you to know that you need look no further than the grace of God that can overwhelm you. The sweet sound of sweet love, sweet unconditional grace and strength and love and hope that is for you today. It's a sweet sound. And today I would love for every one of us to receive that. So I want us to sing this again with the posture of, God, this grace is what I've been looking for all along today. Father, we pray with an openness in our hearts, God. The sweet sound of grace is something that we know we need to be satisfied with. Nothing else will work. Nothing else will do, God. This amazing grace will meet us here, God. And I pray for every heart to be open, every heart to be readily available for your grace to do an overwhelming work, Lord God. I know that you're here. I know that you have something to say. You will meet us in the condition of our heart and fill us like no other can. Especially if this is your first time with us, all you'll get in the mail is a letter from myself and the team say thank you for being here, and then make sure before you leave today that you fill out a prayer request so that we can be praying for you throughout the week. And we are starting a brand new series called You Asked For It. You're going to hear an incredible message in response to a survey that we took back at Easter asking, hey, what do you want to talk about? So really relevant topics that we'll be covering throughout the next couple of weeks. And we'll see in Highlands News some things coming up, some stuff going on around church life. But I'd love for you to meet the people that you're next to, get to know some people, introduce yourself, and then we'll jump right into Highlands News. Go for it.
Jesus, get connected to the church, discover your purpose, and then make a difference with your life. The growth track is divided into four steps, and step one starts today, and we would love for you to join us. Part of step one will be the opportunity to be water baptized. So if God has